Africa, Noma here, and welcome to Learning with Noma, your online comprehensive classroom where we are taking a closer look at our health, at our spirituality, and at finance, taking it one lesson at a time, making sure that we are changing our lives one lesson at a time. Today we are talking about the yellow candle. Today's lesson, yellow candle. So what is yellow candle and why do we necessarily need to use the yellow candle? The yellow candle represents the sun, and for that reason we always associate it with the masculine side of our gender, masculinity. And you're gonna also see that most people use yellow candle when they are trying to connect with their prophetic spirits, or it's associated with prophetic spirits. Our prophet is Thunywa. Most of the time when they are performing rituals associated with isthunywa. So wasani, even with the yellow color in itself, the clothing we talk about isthunywa, the sun, prophetah, they always look up to the skies and mostly to the sun to get their energies. With the yellow candle, we light it in meditation, you light it in prayer, you light it in rituals. So in meditation most, and in prayer, is when people will be looking at enhancing their brain power, you know, having your brain power up there, pushing it up a notch to enhance your focus, your concentration. It helps a lot with the activation of the conscious logic side of the brain. So it's very good for creativity. It's very good when you are trying to prepare for your exams, or when you're a learner, you're trying to prepare for exams. If you're someone who's working, if you just need mental clarity, because it also helps with clearing mental blocks. So if you've got a work project that you need to take upon and you feel a little bit, you know, blocked, your creative channels are not open, they are blocked, you can always light a yellow candle, meditate on it, and it will bring out all the positive energies for you and help you to concentrate more, help you to release those mental blocks and enhance your creative juices. It'll enhance your creativity to come out. And then also when you look at yellow candle, because of its ability to activate positive attitude, you also find it being used most often when we are treating patients who are having depression, patients who are struggling with psychological problems, or who are having post-traumatic stress disease or syndrome, because it helps bring out positive energy, it helps bring up, enhance one's confidence and self-stability. So it just activates those energies in you that will help you be that will help improve your outlook on life, that will help improve your confidence, and it will also help improve, like I said, your stability in life. And it also is used, like I said, when we associate it mostly with spirit, we look at prophetic spirit. So yellow candle is good when you're trying to communicate to your higher self, when you're trying to get a message from the universe about something. The yellow candle is a candle that you can use. It helps a lot to connect to higher self. It helps a lot for one to be concentrated, to be conscious of what they're doing, and it helps with the focus. So if you are really, really struggling to focus, if you're really struggling to get into the moment, be present, the mindfulness part of it, you know, when we talk about being present in the moment in order for you to manifest everything that you want to manifest, you will then incorporate the yellow candle into your meditation, into your prayer, so that it helps increase your focus, it helps increase your concentration, and you are able to then clear all mental blocks. You are able to then become more creative, and you are able to communicate with your higher self better. Because when we talk about creativity does not come from the physical being in the physique alone. It means you need to get inside of yourself. You need to connect to something higher than yourself in order for you to be creative, whether it's at work, whether it's at school, whether it's at whatever that you're doing. Creativity needs a connection of your higher self and your body. And most students use it when they are preparing for their exams. Like I said, it helps clearing of the mental blocks. So most people, when they start preparing for exams and it's a panic, they start meditating with a yellow candle, they start praying over a yellow candle. And it helps a lot to sort of like release all the anxiety by clearing the mental blocks. I think when you are having a mental block, especially if you're studying, being a student myself, I know if you hold that book and you're trying to study and nothing is coming into your head, that in itself causes anxiety. So when you use a yellow candle, you're clearing your mental blocks, you're making sure that you've got high levels of concentration and focus, and you are able to study and prepare for your exams. And in that way also, it increases your intelligence. You sort of like your intellect, you know, your brain power, you just become activated and you want to do it. So yellow candle can be used for that. When it comes to rituals that we can do with a yellow candle, obviously mental block will be one of the rituals that you can do. Light your yellow candle, do everything. But also, with yellow candle is much associated with success, money. So you'll find in most rituals that involve attracting money or manifesting wealth, the yellow candle is used. You light your yellow candle, you channel the right energy to it, and you start manifesting your success. It is one of the candles that is associated with wealth. We all know if we do not have the sun up in the sky, even the plants will suffer. We talk about the process of photosynthesis. So that is for those photosynthesis where we're talking about the plants producing food for themselves in order for them to survive. That is what yellow candle is associated with, success, though the ability for one to produce for themselves or to manifest for themselves what they need in their life, because we all need different things. Your success, your definition of success might not be the same as my definition of success. So with a yellow candle, each person goes through their own process of photosynthesis and they get to manifest what needs to be manifested. And once you have success, once you've got your mental block and you're more creative and you're conscious, logically, you've got brain power, you concentrate more, you're more focused, who will not have confidence? It boosts your self-confidence and it also makes you become a cheerful person. The color yellow is always associated with people who are bubbly and people who are out there, people who are cheerful, people who are happy. Yellow is a color of happiness. So when you've got all those results from using your yellow candle, you're gonna find yourself being cheerful, you're gonna find yourself being happy, you're also gonna find yourself being optimistic about life, understanding that everything happens for a reason, and understanding when your channels are blocked and you have more concentration, you concentrate on things, you don't give up, you learn lessons from whatever that's happening. So it boosts your self-confidence, it boosts your understanding about life, and it makes you have an optimistic look on life. Like we said, once you've done all the rituals, so the results that you might see, you can see that improved financial status, increased attainment of your goals, you will have encouragement to do more mental challenging activities, if I can, I'm trying to find, you know, the best English words, but mental challenging activities will also make you excited. You will wake up in the morning and you'll want to challenge. You'll wake up in the morning and you'll want to be creative. You'll wake up in the morning and you will want to sort of like come up with new ideas and be positive about the outcomes and believe that they will become something else when you start doing them. Your energies in Jay, they will be very positive. And then, because I've also said, you know, yellow candles help with communication with our higher self, and not only with our higher self, also with our personal interaction, me and myself. How do I communicate to myself? And this is, please understand, I'm gonna try to make this easy. When I say personal communication, I'm talking about when I wake up in the morning and I look myself in the mirror, what do I say to myself? I love Java. There's a song of his that's called Ikawe. The video is in the channel, and you can look in the description. The lyrics are there. It says, because you're not ready for the day. If you wake up in the morning and you do not see a hero in the mirror, or you do not see a conqueror in the mirror, go back to bed. You're not ready for the day. So that is what a yellow candle will do for you. You will wake up in the morning, it will boost your self-confidence, and you will see a hero and you'll be ready to face the day. We talked about communication, so that is the communication, your personal, how you talk to yourself in the morning. Higher self, you'll be able to have vivid dreams, you'll be able to hear more, you'll be able to see your visions more clearly, and also not just seeing them, but having an understanding of what they're saying, what your higher self is saying to you. Even in your relationship with others, you will start behaving differently, and you will start communicating differently with confidence, with assertiveness. You won't be passive, you won't be aggressive, but you will have an assertive voice in terms of relationships with other people around you. And yeah, who does not want that? Who does not want to be assertive? Assertiveness is one of the rarest skills that you will find around people in communication, and it's also one of the skills that you can never be perfect in, but you just need to keep to keep training yourself into becoming an assertive human being. And with a yellow candle, meditating and saying your intentions while you meditate on the candle, or while you pray with the candle, that can also help a lot. Other people, when it comes to the connection with your higher self, there's what we call astral travels, the out of this world experiences. If umutwa waba profeta is tunya or unedlozi, when you invoke spirit, I can explain it as those kind of experiences, the out of this world experience, because you are not even aware of what's happening around you. So for those who are having the desire, which is also, again guys, please understand, with this one you need to do it under guidance of someone who will be able to assist you and who understands how they will sort of like bring you back to who you are. So abo gogo nabomkhulu, who want clearer visions, who want to connect more with themselves, whether in vision, whether in dreams, you can use this and it will help you to have those experiences. Those who are maybe struggling to connect, netlozi utwasile usekhaya, you've got your own dumba, but you somehow have lost the connection. You could see it was mangilfuna, ngifuna ukufusela, I don't feel that connection anymore. Yellow candle is there. You can use it to pass that, to connect, because it's tunya. For me, I'll always say it's tunya is your first line of communication, or it's your first line of contact with any kind of spirit, because Istunya talks through dreams, Istunya talks through visions. They are head people. So those are the people that always come forth, even if they don't really need you to be actively practicing in terms of Ubu Profita. But in a way, we all are having the submarine practice of Istunya, even if you didn't do the full is to your process. We all have that yellow speaker that we're wearing, that yellow duke that was needed, that yellow cloth, yellow is always a color that communicates to us. So it is used when you are failing to connect with your higher self, or you're having problems when you've connected with them before but now you're having problems. You can use the yellow candle to pray and to meditate, and with that also you can use it with the blue and the purple candle, which will be a topic for another day, or maybe even a private topic. That's something that will be shared on a stream like this, but yeah, for those who need that, they can sort of like do it. And then we also look at the yellow candle being, I've said it earlier in the video, that it helps with depression. So it helps alter the dark mental mood swings. If you are having mood swings, you are depressed, one day you are happy, bipolar, you can use the yellow candle. It's used in treatment of patients with depression when they are meditating, especially when we're using our own, I'll say, indigenous healing methods, and we incorporate things like incense, candles. If you find that the spirit of someone is very down, they're depressed, you always use a yellow candle to help them sort of like you know, get into the space of good mood. And if you're having bad habits, guys, addictions, yellow candle is also very good to help that. Remember that it clears your mental box. I said that it makes you focus, it makes you concentrate. So when you've got an addiction is a bad behavior or a bad habit that you cannot get rid of. Now you will need to use the yellow candle to meditate, and you will focus on the positive behavior that you want to achieve, or the positive behavior that you want back in your life, and it will help you to clear those mental blocks, and it will help you it will help you to sort of like reconnect with yourself and understand what is happening in your life and get rid of all those negative energies. So a brief summary before I sort of like let it go, because yeah, yellow candle, yo guys, I'm passionate about the color yellow. I'm passionate about the yellow candle. Mina lang talakona, it's at the you know, at that space of istunya se profeto. So I kibuaka ba profeta, I kibuaka ka na lady etsela. I'm just, yeah, I want to talk about the sun. For me, there's so much that I always say, if I did not begin there, I would not be the person that I am today. So yes, yellow is very dear to me, yellow is very close to me, and that's why I don't want to spend much time here, because I might end up just, you know, revealing things that I should not be revealing on a platform like this. It's in fihlo, sacred things of Apogogo Nabumkulu. One day we'll talk about the difference between a secret and a sacred thing. So yellow candles, you use them to help you with you know, okay, let's start the yellow candles, masculinity, the sun, and connection to our spiritual guides, prophetic spirits to be exact, is Tunyaba Profeta. We use it for brain power, we use it to increase our focus and our concentration. It helps with encouraging success or enhancing success into our lives. It clears mental blocks. We can use it when we're depressed, we can use it when we need financial growth, we can use it when we need mental block clearances, we can use it when we need to connect, you know, communication, when we need to improve our communication skills, when we need to communicate not only with our higher selves but also with ourselves selves, like the physical being positive about things, having an optimistic outlook on life. And the yellow candle is used again in order to unblock our solar plexus chakra. So the chakra, I'm just gonna go up a little, the chakra is just right here in your abdominal area, just in the stomach area. That is your solar plexus, and the solar plexus, it's all about personal power and our ability to channel. Just like we said, personal power, confidence, stability, self-esteem, charisma, creativity, you know, divination, where you see your your visions more clearly. We all talk about the solar plexus, because if you can channel from the root chakra and you know, the sacral chakra, you can then, the solar plexus is like there in the middle to connect everything, so it helps to channel. And we are looking at the elements of water and earth when we're looking at the yellow candle. Water, you know, having your water is tumya, they work with water, and earth is tumya, they work very much with earthly things. Abantu abadala basebenzisa isihwasho, and dihwasho ke, in the olden days, you know, we didn't have the bath salts. I remember Goma Uze, unfortunately it's not open now, but there is a well where you can go and you get a different, like sihwasho sezwangofatshe on the earth itself. So that is what we're talking about when we talk about isithunywa, when we talk about the yellow candle. So use it when you need to enhance your confidence, use it when you need to, you know, open up your brain, your creativity, focus more, and just boost your brain power in order for you to get what you need. I hope that you found the information in this video insightful. I hope that you will take your yellow candle and you will put it down, you will take your match. I always say, guys, when you light a candle, light it with intention. Channel the right energies to the candle. If you're struggling with intention, write it down before you light the candle. Put it on the floor next to the candle, or even put your candle holder on top of the paper that you've written. If your intention with the yellow candle is to have mental block clearance, write it, mental block clearance, and light your candle. If it's few things, write them down, but always light your candle with intention. Always understand the intention, and always, always, always make sure that you are concentrating, you are channeling, so that the candle can take all your energy and it can manifest what you need manifested. If you found the information in this video insightful, please hit the like button. Do not forget to hit the subscribe button and share the video so that others can also learn about what you have learned today. We are changing our lives one lesson at a time. If you've got anything to add to what I've said, please leave your comment in the comments area below. Please do like the button, it sort of like helps with the videos to go a little bit up. Subscribe. I'm happy with all the views, guys, but please click the subscribe button. From me, Noma, this is Learning with Noma, changing our lives one lesson at a time. Until next time, till the time.